Oh, who's clicking on what?
So hello, can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes, but someone has clicked on the broadcast, so we are live, so everybody can hear us. But I don't know who has clicked on what.
And stop it.
Okay.
Yeah, but then we'll have to restart it, and that's not what we want.
Okay. Well, good morning, everyone. Then.
Yeah. Good morning. Yeah. Good morning, everybody. We're gonna start in 4 minutes. So wait up. We have still 5 minutes. So be ready. Hello, everybody. We're not live yet. We're going to start this webinar in about 3 minutes. So just hold on. Hello, everybody. We're not live yet. We have not started, so we're going to start in 2 minutes. So hold on 1 minute. Thank you. So good morning, everybody. We're going to start this live webinar. It's me, Martin Loggers. I'm the chief tenant watcher of Supply Chain Media. You might also know me as the editor-in-chief of the Dutch magazine called Supply Chain Magazine and the European quarterly called Supply Chain Movement. I will be the moderator of this webinar. We're going to talk about yard management. This webinar is organized by Pericos and in conjunction with Refresco and Supply Chain Media. So with me, I have three experts. So on the left, you see myself. That's Martin Loggers. So as I said, I'm Chief Tenant Watcher of Supply Chain Media. And with me, I have three experts. First, Frank, welcome of Refresco.
Thank you very much.
Now, could you introduce yourself, what your responsibility and who you are?
Yeah, my name is Frank Guzman. I'm a logistic manager at Refresco and Sittard. I have three departments. It's inbound, outbound, and the supplies. So with this, Sittard is one of the biggest factories from Refresco regarding to bottling cans. Mm-hmm. So, and for this year, the amount of cans we would like to bottle is 1.1 billion of cans bottled. So it's a good challenge.
Okay, and we're going to talk later about the supply chain challenges and yard management issues. And next, Leona Nathans, CEO of Pericos. Welcome. So Leona, welcome. Well, he will be right here. So Alexander Solomon, could you introduce yourself, please?
Of course. Good morning to everybody. Great to see you all. And Frank, thanks for joining as well. I'm Alexander Solomon. I'm responsible for the go-to-market at Pericos. And since 20 years, I'm in the digital business. And maybe the unique story, before I worked at a carrier, and I was also responsible for logistic outbound flows in the industry. So yeah, I really have a clue for the sector and the digitalization of logistics, and glad to be here.
Okay, thank you. Leander, CEO of Pericos, welcome. I hear you, Frank. Leander? We have an issue.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Good morning.
Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah. Good morning, Leander.
Okay. Beautiful. My apologies. Thanks for joining, everyone. Thanks, Frank, as well, for joining and taking your time. So I'm the founder and CEO of Pericos. We started with Pericos 4.5 years ago, and actually, together with my great team, we're now active in multiple countries in Europe as a yard management provider. So, thanks for joining.
Okay. To all of you listening, you know, this webinar will be recorded, and afterwards you will be able to download the PDF of the slides. Everybody is on mute, but feel free to ask questions. So there's a questions panel on the right side, you know, questions pane. You can enter your questions during the webinar, during our conversation, our presentation. But we will have a Q&A at the end. But feel free to start the questions if you need to know something more about what it has been explained during the webinar. So let's make it interactive. But first, Leander, I would like to ask you, now, what is the definition of yard management?
For sure. So actually, we have a few possibilities to look at this definition and to look into yard management. I guess first way of doing it is looking from a macro point of view. Actually, if you look at the existing products that are on the market to digitize supply chain, then actually in the past we had like the TMS systems coming up together with the WMS systems and a lot of warehouse automation connected to this. But if you look at those two systems combined in a typical supply chain, you can see that there's like a gap in between. So actually where the TMS transport management software is really focusing on optimizing transport planning, and lately also dock scheduling has been added, of course, we see that the warehouse management system is really focusing on everything that happens within the warehouse. But the funny thing is, if you set one foot out of this warehouse, out of the building, there's like a gap between the two systems, and this is exactly where yard management is helping in. So in the past, we see that within especially Europe, there's been quite some companies investing in tailor-made software solutions to fill this gap, and for example, to integrate automation in weighing systems, to have a solution to not manually register all trucks coming in. But then most of the times we see there's still quite some possibilities for digitalization, because a lot of people are still involved in this process, a lot of guards or reception personnel. And at the same time, we see that in the US, we have since a year of three, and this is also why this Gartner slide here, we are using this. In the US, since a year of three, there have been some product vendors providing for the first time a yard management software solution. So this is exactly, yes, yeah. For sure.
I have a question about this. You know, where is this gap or this missing link in the supply chain coming from? Has it also to do something to do with the responsibility of the TMS are the carriers, and maybe a logistics service provider or the shipper itself has the WMS, so that's why there's a gap. So the TMS is more on the transport companies, and the warehouse side is more from the shipper or the logistics service provider, and that's why this gap existed.
I guess yes, that's one of the reasons. Of course, the WMS is focusing on the warehouse and is not really thinking about what is happening outside of the warehouse, and the same holds for the TMS. But I guess there's also a logical explanation if you look at how companies are organized, because actually most of the times you have like this transport team, you have the warehouse management team. But then if you look at this gap in between, most of the times this is a bit siloed. Yeah, and you have like a facility management department who is responsible for guarding and stuff.
Yeah.
While actually this is how it is logically organized, but there's quite some costs involved that are sometimes in different cost centers. And this is why it's not always a logical thing to see from within a company, that there's quite some savings and optimizations lying there.
So could you tell me a bit more specific, what are the challenges in the yard?
For sure. So actually, if we look at the most of our customers, actually, where we come across, we see that, of course, some WMS systems are providing a limited functionality for yard management. But most of the times, like this is even a feature you can find in SAP, but most of the times these functionalities are rather limited, where the focus is really on having like an overview of which trailer is on the yard. But the thing is, this overview, it should be managed manually. So it means that you're not able to really drive processes and learn from input, from example, from drivers or from technology. So I guess the functionalities are rather limited. So what happens and what we see at customers is that people start finding their own solutions, start building their own solutions. We come across a lot of Excel. We call them sometimes Godzilla Excels, where you have like this huge amount of people working together on one Excel file, trying to solve their operational problems. I guess it's logical that you start doing this, because in some sites the volume can be quite high. And if this is not really in place, then we see a lot of resource intensive processes. So walkie-talkie communication with the operators who are acting on the yard, like a shunter driver. We see a lot of pen and paper solutions. Of course, this comes with quite a burden of mistakes happening and information being lost. While at the same time, the challenges have been growing lately. You have a lot of languages within the truck driver, so it's not always easy to make things clear. So things are not really happening as it should most of the times. And most of all, there's no real-time insight in what is happening. And this is something we really see at a lot of our customers.
And I also think, the yard is not just a parking lot for trucks. It's a real process. And if you look at this visualization on the screen with entering the compound or the yard and registration and different kind of buildings where you can dock. So it's a process in itself.
Exactly. And this is like, when we talk about this visibility topic, actually, this is exactly what we mean, when you're not having a good view on what is happening on your site, how can you even start of optimizing processes? If you don't know how long a truck is waiting on average or which carrier is maybe most of the times late, you don't have the tools, you don't have the management insights to really make things better or to flip to another carrier, for example, because he's not performing well. And actually, this is exactly the baseline, I guess, for a yard management system. It should provide you with a way of automating your typical process flows for each logistics flow. So, for example, you have an inbound process, you have an outbound process, you have some specific processes next to this. Well, actually, most of the times, this process should always happen the same time. A truck comes in, the truck registers, should be called off when the load is ready, maybe a weighing process in between. And it's exactly this process that gets designed in a yard management system and that then gets automated by connecting with hardware, by connecting with self-service kiosks and so on.
Over to you, Frank. Do you recognize this kind of visualization? You have a huge bottling company. So is it similar in your environment that you have this kind of different kind of buildings and flows on your yard?
Yeah, absolutely. We see the same things that were just mentioned. We have the same challenges, let me say it like that. We see that a lot of trucks are coming on times that even much sooner than they should be here. So all those trucks, they are coming on the yard. It creates a not safe environment. So yes. We see a lot of things. We already made some changes in our system, just what was mentioned about an Excel file. So we have a pre-pick file so that we already know when the truck is coming into the at the counter in from our site, that they already know where the goods are already stacked on which dock. In the previous time, they were always standing somewhere on the premises, and they had to wait. And with this system for Peri Pass, this all will be solved. So it's a great system. What I see, we're already busy with some sessions now, and it's evolving.
Now, when you look at the slide, you know you have a new production site and logistics facility. Could you tell us more about it and how it relates to the yard?
Mm-hmm. Well, this is the new site for the warehouse. We have 24 docks on that site. Mm-hmm. In total, it's 27,500 square meters. And normally we will do on a busy day, it will be 130 trucks on a daily basis that we can handle. So what is already mentioned there, we are the world's largest independent bottler. And setup is the biggest site from the Benelux. So we're the first site will be getting Peri Pass on our site. So we are going to be doing the pilot in this. And hopefully the rest will also follow. So what we see is that we have now the trucks are coming in, and what I said at the counter in, they will report over there, and then you see that all the trucks have to wait over there. So it's causing a problem, a traffic jam on the streets. With the Peri Pass solution, we're now going to have an truck parking on the other side, and it will be much more leaner, let me say like that, to get the trucks in. So they have to go to the column where they have to register, and that will all be done by the truck driver himself, and not anymore by the people from Refresco. Mm-hmm. So after that, they will get a ticket on a cell phone and a PIN code. And after everything is ready on the docks, they will get a notification via text message that they can come in. After that, they will go to the dock. They will dock on, and they will report in at the office. and then the loading will start. And when the loading is done, yeah, it is much, much more quicker done than we are doing now. So
What are the time slots you are giving a truck? Do they have a window, and how big is the time window for a truck?
We have a time window for every truck normally for 1 hour.
Okay.
With this, we can reduce it until half an hour, three quarters of an hour.
And how many trucks do you invite at a maximum? So how many? What is the maximum amount of trucks you want to have? In the parking lots or in your yard.
The maximum of trucks that we want in the parking lot is at least 15. Okay. And on the yard, we also can have this on the docks. We try to optimize it as fully as planned. So if we have every dock fully planned, then it will be okay.
So you want to create a flow all through the entering the yard from the parking lot registration onto the dock to keep it all smooth, just like the bottling itself, to create a nice flow.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
So then that's what I said. We are our goal is for this year to aim at 1.1 billion cans of bottles. Mm-hmm. So these are a lot of pallets, and we want to ship it, and that's why we are on 130 trucks on a daily basis.
Okay, thanks. Alexander, could you explain, because this is in the bottling environment, what kind of industries this yard management application is viable?
Yeah, for sure. First of all, Frank, impressive figures, and we are really proud to cooperate with you. What you can see here, after being 5 years on the market, we have learned where our abilities are fitting best. And these are these four sectors. This is food beverage, where also Frank and Refresco belongs to. This is manufacturing. This is the logistic world. And this is retail. And maybe, we are not a startup. I would call Peripass a scale-up, but we managed the last 4 or 5 years really to convince big brands about our offering and service. And this is what we're really proud on. And in these sectors, logistic really is key. Maybe you know this from the retail world, they're fighting for cents. So logistic and digital logistic can be really a competitive factor. And that's why these companies already have decided to go for the hidden diamond. I always call the yard management, it's a hidden diamond, because nobody really cared for it. In the past, first the people started to reduce freight costs. Then they introduced maybe a transport management system. They cared for their warehouse management system, but nobody cared about yard. So gentlemen, and to all the audience, now it's time to care for the yard. And if you're in one of these four sectors, really, you can do a lot. You can go for savings and efficiency.
May I ask something? When you look at these different kind of industries, when you look at logistics, look at these logistics service providers, they have a lot of sites. So do you already see also within this customer framework, these customers, that they have a rollout when they have implemented the first one, that they say, okay, this has worked so smoothly, we want all our locations with this kind of yard management?
Yeah, definitely. So it's most of the time the same story. It's similar what Frank has told. First, the clients, they decide to go for a pilot site. And after this is working successfully, normally they realize it after 3 or 6 months, then they think about the rollout, not only in the same country, but also international. We have all these discussions now with XPO, with Essas, with Kühn and Nagel, and it's quite logical because they realize, okay, the hidden diamond is working. So let's go for the other sites.
Can you explain more about, it is a hidden diamond, but so what is the business case? What are the benefits?
Yeah, for sure. Could you maybe go? Yes, this is perfect. So normally these are our 5 main modules, what you see here. If you would imagine, for example, on the left side, another module, I just want to explain how is it is located in the supply chain. This could be a time slot booking system from a TMS provider. So Refresco, if I'm not wrong, is using Transporium, for example. And then we collect this data from the time slot booking. And this is the point of marrying within our Yard solution. So first we have the Yard control tower. Here we create a digital twin of your yard. So for example, when Frank is going out of his office and going to the yard and viewing with his eyes, he will see a lot of truck movements. But yeah, this is quite exhausting to go there every hour. So he just has to click our software and then every truck is visualized. That's why I call it a digital twin. You see all the trucks waiting, which are on the parking spaces and which are at the ramps, and you have a clear overview and you can dispatch and guide them. So the first really business case is real-time insight. When we go to the second box, this is Yard Task Management. Here, Peripass allows you to involve all operational people at your yard. This can be an operational handler. This can be a shunter driver, a forklift driver. And maybe you know this from your own yard. All these people that go frequently to a dispatching office or to a warehouse office. What is my next task? And then they get the simple answer. Please collect container number 12 and bring it to ramp number 23. And you lose a lot of time. With our solution, we give them all the tasks on a mobile application. Then they can prioritize the task. They can checkmark them. Task is fulfilled. Or they can make photos, for example, if it's necessary regarding loading security. So you here really you save a lot of time because you do not send your people frequently to a point where they get new tasks. The third one, the Yard Asset Match. Now we have implemented our solution around about 90 times in Europe. What we often hear is 3 times a month we lose a trailer. Every day we are looking for trailers. We do not know where are the trailers, the containers. We do not know which loads are on which trailers. So if you implement Peripass, these times are gone. We have a zero mistake policy here. And we really create a digital twin as well of all your assets. You know exactly where a container is. You know exactly which goods are on which container. And believe me, you will not send a wrong trailer or container to the wrong customer. If we go to box number 4, this is the self-service access. I guess you know this. Truck drivers are coming from many countries. This can be from Philippines, Poland, Russia, from the Arabic world. And there is a language barrier. So I have my mother tongue German and I'm able to speak English quite fluently. But I do not speak Polish or Russian. So if I would meet a Russian truck driver, this would be a chaos. Then I have to use my arms and my legs to communicate. And this happens every day at the portier, at the guard. What we are doing, Peripass is the host of the truck driver in their mother tongue. And that's quite cool. Yeah, so I do not mean it bad and it's not blaming, but also the education level of the drivers is not that low at that high. So they speak their mother tongue and maybe a little bit of English. Now the time is different. Peripass is the host in the mother tongue. We welcome the driver and we guide them through the whole process in their mother tongue. And that's really cool. So at least this is the feedback we get every day from our clients. And the fifth one is yard automation. Last but not least, never neglect this. What we are doing, for example, if you have recurring flows or if you have a weighing bridge, we completely integrate it into the digital process. So for me, one of the most boring jobs in the world is sitting at a weighing bridge. Every 20 minutes a truck is arriving. You have to write down a figure of the weight and then you wait the next 20 minutes for the next truck. So this is really wasting of time. We at Peripass, we completely integrate it without manual support in the whole process. And maybe to finish this view in the supply chain, if you would imagine on the right side another box, this could be, for example, a real-time visibility provider. So you remember at the beginning, I talked about on the left side about time slot booking. Then you have the Peripass offering. And after the truck has left the yard, yeah, we follow up with real-time visibility. So Peripass is really a cool complementary product to TMS providers, to ERP systems. Yeah, that's why it's working that well.
I was wondering, you know, there are impressive figures of savings. So how did you calculate this kind of cost savings?
Yeah, we made it based on the 90 projects we have already done. Mm-hmm. And when you look on the first two modules about control tower and task management, here really you can do much more with the same amount of people you have at the yard. Or if you have a stable business, yeah, then you can save some money. And I mentioned some of the reasons why. The first is the real-time insight. So you can dispatch much more quicker instead of if you would not know about the real-time insight. Where is a truck? Where is a ramp available? So here you really speed up. At the yard task management, and I hope I've explained it already during my explanation, you do not send the people every 1 hour to the office because they need new tasks. They are frequently feeded with tasks.
Yeah.
The other three cases here, really it goes about money. If you do not lose three trailers a month, you save a lot of money and you do not annoy your clients. There is also a psychological aspect behind. You really satisfy your clients. The self-service access, yeah, if you do not need human beings to welcome somebody at the portier, at the reception desk, I guess this is self-explaining. And the same, if you do not have your people sitting at the weighing bridge, because a software like Peripass is doing it, yeah, then the savings, I guess, they are self-explaining.
Yeah. Maybe interesting to add here is that the savings that are calculated on this slide, yeah, so the bottom row with the two trucks stands for an average number of trucks of 100 per day at a typical site, and the three trucks row is about an average site with 180 to 200 trucks a day.
Okay, thanks. So in my opinion, it's also, you know, when you have this kind of environment, you make your visitors, the truck drivers, feeling welcomed, and that's also very important that this whole process is going smoothly, and that's also an aspect apart from the savings. Alexander, maybe you can talk a bit more about the possibilities you explained, the business cases, but maybe.
Yes, for sure. So actually, if you look at a typical process, and of course you have exceptions here, but we wanted to make it a bit tangible on what specific features and value the yard management system can bring at each typical step. So actually, as Alexander already explained, everything starts, of course, with knowing what truck is coming. So the first box there, the pre-registration. But actually, no worries. It's not because you're not having a slot management system or a slot booking system that you really cannot benefit from the value. Because if you look at typical customers, what do we do? If you have a slot booking system, for example, for all your outbound transports, then it's quite easy to use these slot bookings as a starting point for those trucks to register with the slot booking number. Yeah? But imagine for inbound, most of the people we come across, they use, for example, an ERP system to place their purchase orders. You can easily connect this data as well and say, hey, we have truck drivers for inbound coming in, we have truck drivers for outbound coming in. The inbound ones will use, for example, a purchase order number to identify themselves, while the outbound ones will use a slot booking reference. And this is how we start using the data that is already within the organization available as a starting point to know what trucks to expect and to let them easily register as well later on in the process. If you look at the second step, the registration of the truck drivers, of course, it doesn't mean you need to do everything at the same time. Yeah, this is the holistic view of what you can do if you automate everything. The next logical step is then to automate the registration. Here on this little drawing, you see those kiosks standing in a little booth. Yeah, we have multiple approaches here. Yeah, we have customers who have these kiosks at truck height, where you have multiple truck entries next to each other with a barrier. Providing trucks from driving in without registering. But I guess the most logical and economical way of doing it, if you have the space, is to create a waiting parking where trucks arrive, they park their truck, they can go out to a little kiosk or multiple kiosks who are a bit under a shed so that they are not in the rain, and they can easily register themselves in their own language, so without the need for human people there doing this job one after the other. This registration process, of course, you can do this, you can configure this very basically. Yeah, let's just register the PO, the name of the carrier, for example, and some other information. But most yard management systems, and especially Peripass, we also provide the possibility to, for example, facilitate certification, for example, a security test that can be done by the driver, or you can as well for TAPA warehouses or high value goods, facilitate those compliance checks as well within this kiosk process. So this is quite interesting, I guess, so that you can really make the saving. Actually, we get to the situation where the trucks are registered. And actually, this is where the digital twin plays a big role for the warehouse operators, of course, because from this point on, you have like this digital twin showing you, hey, what trucks have arrived and what trucks are momentarily at docks being loaded or unloaded. And this visibility, I guess, is really what is making the ball game difference, because we had a lot of customers who were sometimes not even aware of the chaos at their site because they were just focusing on their warehouse at that point in time. And I guess by having this registration, by having a dashboard and seeing the trucks already on site and the trucks being handled, this is exactly where the value is coming from. So actually, next steps and where you can still add extra value, I guess it's logical then to dispatch the trucks to a warehouse. Most of the times what we do here and what we really advise is to use text messages. Make it simple. So the moment you call off a truck by drag and dropping it to a dock, this dispatch moment is captured by a service that can drive access control, and that is also sending text messages in the native language of the driver to this driver. So for example, if you drive into Alpro, you get a text message, hey, this is Alpro, we are ready for you, please continue to zone C, dock 23, and use the pin code 1234 to open the barrier. So actually, Peripass, under the hood of our system, we have integrations with access control systems, with IP video, with ticket printers, so you can drive any automation necessary, as you see in step 4, to allow this truck to really enter. You can even take pictures of this truck to detect any damage. And this is, I guess, what you can also do at the exit. Yeah? And in between, as Alexander explained, we also have this Yard Operator app, which can be used by different users on the yard. We have seen some very cool examples of companies using this operator app to also, for example, provide quality assurance checks on inbound goods. But we had exactly the same. So for example, I remember Alpro, for every truck going outside of the European Union, they have like this policy where they document the full load with pictures. Yeah, this is the kind of work you can easily win half an hour a day, because at the end of the day, those people were using a normal camera and had to sort all these pictures from a USB stick into the different folders. This is all something of the past. You can easily document quality assurance checks, 0.7, 13 point controls. You can easily facilitate those processes. And last but not least, when the truck is going out, also this is captured. So you can easily say, hey, if we don't have the compliance checks yet done, if the paperwork is not yet presented to the truck driver, we can prevent the truck from driving out. Yeah, so this access control system, which we integrate with, well, this access control system can be configured that it's only allowing the truck to go out the moment the necessary process steps have been fulfilled. So I guess this is a bit a full view on the different possibilities you have with such a yard management system.
It's quite interesting, but it's also quite interesting that you mentioned, you know, there are different flows, inbound and outbound flows. And, you know, for sure, almost per definition, those inbound flows are somewhat different than outbound flows. And it is good to differentiate on those processes as such. So do you also assess this up front? What are the inbound flows? What are the characteristics and what are the outbound flows? Maybe you want to take pictures for outbound because then you are ready to deliver. So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
In an average project, to be very transparent and open about this, yeah, in an average project, we have like 5 to 10 logistics flows at most sites. Of course, the big majority of volume is most of the times in inbound and outbound, maybe divided into multiple categories. So, for example, ingredient and chemicals.
Yeah.
But you also have some specialties, yeah, like waste, garbage collection, like contractors coming in. This is all possible to facilitate. And actually, this we do typically in an analysis process where we have multiple sessions with the different teams of the customer to really get to this point where we really understand the processes, where we capture the full needs of every flow. This is configurable. And I guess this is an important learning I would like to share with everyone here. I guess the main difference with a yard management system in comparison with a tailor-made software solution here is that it's configurable. And yeah, this is the pitfall, you know. If you build a weighing automation, yeah, it will work. Within a few months or a few years, yeah, you have to change your process, you're growing, you're changing the site layout. And this is, I guess, the most important benchmark to use when looking at yard management systems. Those are products, you know, it's configurable. So for the first time, the initial implementation is, of course, done by our teams, but we train the different users within the company to also adapt themselves the system to future needs to, for example, add an extra flow if you get into a more specific production line and these kinds of possibilities.
Yeah, and I can imagine, you know, what Alexander explained, if you have a customer, a 3PL company with a lot of sites, not all the sites look the same. So yeah, you can copy paste to a large extent, but some sites have do extra, you know, a waiting area, whatever. So you have to configure it also when you are within one company with similar sites, but not completely the same.
Yeah, for sure. And this is our challenge, and actually this is quite fun for us as well, to be honest, because yeah, the most simple sites is where you have the space. You know, we have, yeah. For example, we work for Intermarché in France. You know, in France there is still space. It's not like in the Netherlands or in Belgium. So at those sites you have like the room. To make it quite simple, you have one big entrance, you have one big waiting parking lot, and it's simple then. But I guess when we look into the Netherlands and especially in Belgium as well, we come across some factories who are like, yeah, really in somewhere in half in the between the city center still. We have like a very specific paper factory where we have more than 7 entrances that are facilitated, where space is really limited. But even for those specific situations, we have features to really provide solutions when you have, for example, only 4 waiting parking spaces next to your entrance. Then we have features like providing a remote queue, and when then one truck is going in, the other one already is called off. So all those functionalities are configurable and out of the box available. So I guess this is then what we get our rocks off from. Yeah.
Okay. So can you explain what is your usual yard management system approach?
Yeah, I guess Leander explained quite well what Caripass is able to do. For us internally, the big challenge was our exercise how to offer it to the market. And we have decided, I guess it's a cool solution. We have decided to offer 3 bundles and to offer also to go for very quickly for to have quick wins. So the first bundle, it's about the yard control tower and the yard task management. This is a cloud only offering. You do not have to invest in hardware. You do not have to adapt your site or your layout. It's just using our software. Yeah. And within a few months, I would say around about in average 3 months, you are able to benefit from the Peripass offering. That's why it's mentioned here as quick win. The change management is limited. Yeah, you know, whenever you introduce a system, you have to train a lot of people, you're implementing new processes. But here really, when implementing the first two modules of Peripass, you really, it's quick win. It's the low hanging fruits you can easily go for. If you add a yard asset management, means to take care for your asset, for your containers and trailers. Yeah, this is the next bundle. Here you already add value. That's why we call it the bigger value. And if you go for the full service offering of Peripass, including the self-service access and the yard automation, there is the biggest value. But also here you have to do some hardware invest and you have to do some construction because a kiosk needs a cable and things like this. You have to go for signation. But we support all these processes. No worries, you're not alone. At Peripass, we have 50 experts every day, 8 to 10 hours. We do nothing else than improving yard situations. Yeah, that's why also from our side, you get some consultancy here, which we offer for free. We do not charge our consultancy. So these 3 bundles, normally they will satisfy your needs.
Okay, and you know, Frank, at Refresco, you know, when you look at this approach, so what have you chosen, and how are you planning to develop further?
Well, we chose the biggest value. So this was for us the best option, because also the self-service access was very important for us, because that will reduce also some waiting time and everything. So we also created for that, and yeah, what I said, a truck parking, which was not there in the beginning. So yeah, this is for us. Is this the best approach? So also, yeah, if I see how the how we have the sessions build up now with everything and with Veripass, I think it's going very good. And what was just mentioned, yeah, we need some construction works have to be done. So for us, yeah, the biggest value is that one.
Martin, if I may just add one thing to Frank. Normally what our clients are doing, they choose a two steps approach. So they really say, okay, I would love to have the quick wins. So then we go for the quick project, and later on, it can be 3, 4, 5 months later, then we follow up with the other modules. So, so then you have really all the benefits out of it, and you do not have to wait that long before you can go for the low hanging fruits. So this is a typically two step project approach. Refresco has decided to really go quickly for everything, what we also love, of course, but there are both options.
Yeah, one of the things that was in the past is that I knew Veripass from a previous employer from XPO. So that's when I came over to Refresco. It immediately caught my eye, and I saw the benefits of it. So I made contact with Veripass in this case, and also we set up everything for the quotation. So we discussed all our needs, and what I saw within the yard what was happening here, and for that I think Veripass has had the best solution what was on the market. So so in this case, yes. That's why we went for that.
Thanks. If you look at I just wanted to thank you, Frank, for the compliment. And maybe, Frank, when the project is done, you could look for a new job in another segment of our offering. So,
Frank, if you look at this phased approach, could you elaborate a bit more? You know, how you approach this in phase one and phase two.
Phase one was that we first checked, okay, what were the needs, what were the problems, what were the challenges. I set them up, did it with a team, with my own team, and yeah, we had some quick wins to do. So in the first case, we made what was mentioned in earlier, we made a pre-pick file in Excel, whatever, so that we already could adapt a little bit. Afterwards, we had the sessions with Veripass in this, and now we already had, I think, about 4 or 5 sessions done. Now our local IT is integrating in the sessions also. So in those sessions, we defined everything what was needed for the yard management system. When the trucks have to come in, what we need to do with the dispatch, how it should be done, which languages to be chosen, and everything. So this is the phase that we are in now. I also had to make it sure that the our local management team knew also, which I'm a member of, who knows also what we wanted to do. So I created a budget for that as well, related to the quotation that we had, and now it started to beginning to live also within the organization, within the organization of the Benelux, not only in at Sittard, but also in the Benelux for that. So every eyes, all the eyes from the Benelux are on set out in this case. So we hope that we can, continue as soon as possible now with our IT and with the sessions. And I hope we can implement it within, I think about June, that we can go live.
Okay. And if I look at the slide with the phase approach, I get it. You start with the inbound flow, and I also see that you have registered timestamp to trace all the trucks. So that's what you also okay. And also using dock sensors. So
yeah, I'm going to use dock sensors in this case. That was one of the things that we were not sure about in the first. Quotation. So we checked out if it was fulfilling our needs. And very quickly we saw, okay, this is the best solution for that. Also to create dock sensors. With this, there is a lot of automation going on in that yard management system. And we see a lot of if I do the return of investment, let me say it like that, it would be within 1 year.
Okay, cool. You mentioned you're using Transporeon and SAP. Do you consider it hard to integrate this kind of system with those systems?
No, Transporeon we're busy with integrating now, and it will be integrating in end of March, begin April, and all assessments would be done. And this is what was the first step towards also using a Peripass also, because it really easily connects to each other.
Okay. And here it is mentioned that the phase two, the next step would be your task management outbound. So what are you going to do with the outbound? Is he check trail trucks, seals and photos?
We have also that, so what we're facing now is that we always have to do, we have to take pictures from the loading and how they are loaded and everything, and we have to upload it, and that takes a lot of time. So people are busy with that, they have to put it in the right file with the right CMR and everything, so everything has to be documented, and it's really, really taking a lot of time. With this system from Peripass, it's very easily done. You don't have to do that. It will be all done automatically, and that's it's a huge effort and a huge saving, and it's so much easier. And my team is looking forward with working with Peripass in this case, and they're all excited about it.
And I can imagine also for quality reasons that in the future, it would be way easier to check where things might have gone wrong with damage and also with demurrage and insurers, that kind of stuff.
Yes, absolutely. You just have to type in the CMR number or whatever, and you can easily extract everything what you need, and you can share it with the customer.
Do you know when to expect to go into this second phase of also the outbound flow?
The outbound flow we already defined is already defined in the sessions now. So what I just mentioned, we're just waiting for our local IT to enter the next step, and from there on, we can go and build, so we can put everything in motion.
Okay, thanks for the explanation. Looking now into the future, I was wondering, what will yard management will look like in 5 or 10 years? Maybe Alexander or Leander.
Yeah, happy to elaborate a bit the vision that we are following and are working on hard, of course. So actually, in short term, I guess many of you already know real-time visibility and what it's about. So for those who don't, you have some multiple players now providing services to really give an ETA, a predictive ETA, a predicted ETA that is really trustworthy when it comes to what truck and when it will arrive. So this is actually software vendors who are working and integrating with the different fleet management systems of carriers, So of course, you don't need to do it with every carrier. And these real-time visibility players like Shipeo or Sixfold that you have in Europe, we really believe that this can make a great change. For now, we see those players providing a dashboard. And with that dashboard, you can easily see, hey, this truck will be 1 hour late, this one will be 2 hours early. But I guess this is only where it starts, yeah? So we are now working hard together with Transporeon, by the way, because we announced a partnership with them last week. Mm-hmm. We are now working hard on providing, you know, that extra value where this real-time visibility data is used to advise to warehouse operators, for example, to start earlier with another truck because the other one will be late anyway. So I guess the data is already there, but really helping you make the decision and advise you the right changes in your schedule is the next step. It's almost a way of looking into the future. And this is where we are really working hard on now together with Transporeon, where we feel that a lot of change will come because we see a lot of customers where they just work according to schedule. You know, the whole load of the next truck is set in the warehouse, but then this truck is not showing up for another 3 hours. And actually this is warehouse capacity down the drain. This is warehouse capacity that could have been invested into a truck that was already there. And I guess this kind of logic is what we see as a short-term, new feature.
Can I comment on that? You know, I know those providers like Shipeo and Sixfold and Project 44 quite well. The basic thing is why, you know, this kind of software is popping up. They extract external data into their systems to make the expected time of arrival dynamic. So based on the weather, traffic jams, but also other things happening, all this data included, or even a shop being closed at a retailer, and that has some impact on the whole chain and could impact also the ETA. So that's basically where this kind of new software vendors like Transporeon or Shipeo with this real-time transport visibility is popping up. So that's why that's new. But go ahead. And what is happening on the midterm?
Exactly. Maybe to add here, it's indeed new, but to use this as well in the yard management processes is of course our goal then. So thanks for adding this.
Yes.
So in midterm, and I guess this is then looking a bit more into the future. Yeah. So what we see is that with the dock sensors, as expressed by Frank, they will be used as well. What we already do is we narrow the view we have on the yard to a dock level. Yeah. So that means that if you look, for example, to the history of a specific truck, you're able to see when it has been booked, when it has arrived on site, when it has entered the site, when it has arrived at the dock, and when it has left again at the dock, and when it has left the site. So actually, this gives you a very detailed whereabouts of this truck on every different occasion that happened on the site. Of course, this is very good when you have trucks live loading, but the moment you start moving and storing assets like containers, like trailers, like reefers on your site, it's not that simple. Just occupy a full site with dock sensors and it's not giving you a really closed view on everything, because a dock sensor is just saying, hey, I have a truck on me, or hey, I have a trailer on me. It's not saying what trailer. And since the whole industry is based on a high rotation of trailers and assets like containers, it's hard to equip them all with systems to track them. So what we're really focusing on a midterm is a way of tracking assets on a yard, and we are doing this with vision learning. So for the moment, we are running a proof of concept at the site of Assis in Belgium, where we use cameras put on the site, looking down to the site, and actually using vision learning technology to detect those trailers and to follow them automatically on a site. You might wonder why we do all this effort. Well, the thing is, now with those dock sensors, we already provide the possibility to really limit the number of mistakes. But I guess to really make it closed, to close this little gap still left, and to really have the ability to fully autonomously track every movement on a site, this is what we believe in, the technology that will bring this difference and this possibility. It is also enabling to other use cases where we get quite some demand for, being the traffic management system and the driver guidance. So we have quite some customers with complex sites who ask us, hey, could you not provide the possibility to really guide the traffic? You know, if we're unloading a ship, we don't want any traffic from trucks crossing this this loading activity. If we have like a maintenance at the technical installation, we don't want any truck passing by there. These kinds of possibilities we will facilitate in a traffic management system. And then the driver guidance is really focusing on guiding drivers on site still more in detail. We are here working on dynamical signalization and possibilities to give detailed driver guidance on site. I guess this is midterm, but in the end, we really see, and here you see in the picture, by the way, an example of Volvo who is experimenting with this autonomous shunter. We really believe that within 5 to 10 years, and I believe it is also the term you used, Martin. I believe within 5 to 10 years, we will have the autonomous trucks coming anyway. And this is really what we are looking forward to, what we are already facilitating now. And the moment this truck without a driver is arriving at your gate, I guess the best chances to be able to handle them will be with Veripas then.
Yeah. I can imagine, to equip this autonomous yard operations and this driverless trucks, you have to be digitalized. You know, you have to have get rid of those humongous Godzilla Excel, so otherwise it won't work. You know, you get a lot of manual interference, and you won't connect with this driverless world.
Exactly. Yeah. So I think the first step is knowing what is happening already today. Actually, from this starting point, it's quite simple, and that's the good news. There's already a lot of value to be captured today. So I guess the starting point enables you to do savings, enables you to be better in managing the situation and the different carriers. And I guess this possibility that is already achievable today will be a next step to the long-term situation of autonomous operations.
Yeah, I was wondering, Frank, how do you see the future? Jolanda has explained the short, midterm, and long-term. Frank, what do you foresee for the future for Refresco?
What do I see for the future for Refresco? If I look at here at that setup, I think we can only make the steps ahead in this case. We have a lot of ambition, let me say like that. And Veripas is fitting in exactly towards our needs. For the long term, for the Benelux, I hope that that they also will see the benefits in what we are doing here in Sittard, and that they will go for that as well. So, I think it's the best solution for us.
Yeah, but do you I don't hold you for it, but do you expect autonomous driverless trucks at Refresco arriving in 5 years or 10 years? How do you foresee the future?
Yeah, I hope that we can that there will be one of the things that will start, but I know within the logistics for more than 30 years, and I've seen logistics evolve in a lot of ways. So I hope that that this will happen as well.
So we're getting at the end of the webinar. We have 2 minutes to go. So if you have questions, in the audience, feel free to ask right now. I have one question to Leander exactly. So. Or Alexander, how do you recognize that you are in need of yard management? So how do you recognize your problems to say, okay, I need something to do about it?
Yeah, I guess, Leander, if I may, what we really have experienced the last year, especially that the inbound leads are getting much more. So of course, we try to do good marketing. But we really saw in the last 6 to 9 months that the inbound leads are getting heavily more. And this is for me the answer that there is need of the market, because logistic managers like Frank, they realize, hey, I have to do something. This is again the hidden diamond. So this is on, and the other story is that we realize it in talks to our clients. So when you remember what Leander has told about this picture of the yard, all the pain points which are there, they are moving the people, and they realize, okay, there is a solution on the market. So this would be my answer to your question, Martin.
All right. So we are on the hour. May someone to add? So I would like to thank Frank, Leander, and Alexander. So final word from you, Frank. What is it? What you can say to the audience? What would you recommend?
What I could recommend is that the huge amount of savings that you have within this certain amount of security within your yard, which introducing this system is huge. It's very huge. So I would that everybody would reconsider and looking at their yard, because that's what just Alexander told. It's really a hidden diamond.
To wrap up, Leander, final words from you, from your side.
Well, I guess thanks, Frank, first of all, and I would invite everyone who is interested in this to explore possibilities. I believe you will be surprised about what's already possible, and feel free to contact us. Of course, we would be happy to inform you about what's possible.
I got a quick question, maybe for Alexander. From what number of trucks and docks it is interesting to invest in this kind of solution, Alexander?
Yes, we have created an ICP. We call it an ideal customer profile ourselves. So if you have 60 truck movements a day at your yard, it really makes sense to introduce a solution like Peripass. And it's not the number of ramps, it's really the number of truck movements. And you can combine inbound and outbound. If you have 60 and more, then it's worth to implement yard management solution.
All right. We keep it in the hour, otherwise, people have maybe some other meetings to go to. You see here the contact details, so feel free to contact each of us. Again, Frank, Leander, and Alexander, thank you for joining me and for explaining this interesting hidden diamond or missing link in the supply chain, I would say sometimes. And for the audience, I would like to thank you for watching and participating. So thank you for this. This webinar has been recorded, will be made available later on, and you will be able to download the presentations. So thank you for watching, and maybe see you next time. Thank you all, and okay. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Bye, thank you.